just declared war on the U.S. The Georgians hit our communications, transportation, power grids. We still don't know how extensive the damage is. Your mission just became critical. You know what you need to do.
Greetings, fellow orphans. Welcome to Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell, Stealth Action Redefined. It has been a long time, 6 months to be exact, and I was actually shifting and I got a new job as game developer, and I just couldn't really, you know, find the time to actually just start playing the game, start covering a new game. I've been meaning to cover this series for a long time, and this is one of my favorite series, and yeah, so. That's just the thing. I just found the time after a long time. I thought this is it. But it's now or never. Got to progress the channel further, and here we are. So, without further ado, let's go.
Canceled a trip to Georgia this morning after the suicide bomb assassination of that country's president by separatist rebels from the Abkhazia region. Continued fighting in the Abkhazia and South Ossetia regions has hindered Georgia's hopes of integration into Western institutions. Industry baron Combain Nicolad seized power today in a bloodless coup, installing himself in the presidential palace behind a wall of political and military support. The charismatic billionaire plans on holding elections within a matter of days to affirm his seat of power, and promises a pristine and profitable relationship with America and the West. Bringing high-speed fiber optic connectivity to areas of Eastern Europe that less than a decade past didn't have telephones. The technological leap is due largely to the efforts of rising information industries in the Netherlands, and especially Georgia, where the Vice President called his visit to Georgia an honor, and called Georgian President Combain Nicolad a man with his eyes on the future.
CIA Training Farm, Camp Peary, Virginia, August 7th, 2004, 0601 hours. Prove that you're the right man for the job. As Agent Sam Fisher, you have been recruited to spearhead the operational arm of National Security Agency's Third Echelon Initiative. Before being sent into the field, you must demonstrate that you possess the skills to undertake dangerous and covert solo missions.
Fisher, I can't believe you beat me here.
I like to be early. Hello, Colonel.
You can use my name. The room's safe.
Lambert.
Good to see you again. I trust NSA orientation is going well?
Well enough. Everybody's been real coy about what exactly I'm allowed to know.
It's the nature of the agency. We don't let any one person know everything, which means we've all got to work together.
Even though I'll be out there alone.
You'll be transmitting to us in more ways than you can imagine. And we'll be online through your earpiece and OPSAT.
And that's how we're handling training.
Yep. Sorry to make you run the course. I know you've been taking care of yourself.
I haven't been in the field in years.
Sure. But trade graft is something you don't forget. It's like riding a bike.
Or wearing high heels.
Be careful, Fisher. Everything we say is being monitored. You know how nervous the brass is about exercising the fifth freedom.
I'll be good.
Be better than good. Third Echelon is a brand new initiative. The role aggressive intelligence operations will play in NSA's future will depend largely on your performance. I'll see you on the far side of the course.
All right, Sam, let's get started. Can you hear me clearly?
Hi there.
Good. That means the implanted speaker is working correctly. Now, the technicians here want to calibrate your equipment. Can you turn to the red emergency light on the wall to your left? Great. Now the one on your right. Okay, same thing for pitch. Look for another light up in the rafters on the ceiling. Excellent. Now look for one on the ground in front of you.
All right, Fisher. We'll get through this as quickly as possible. We'll start simple. Climb up onto that ledge, over that pool.
Well, beam aside. First off, we're going to start off with an Easter egg. And this game plays a lot like Prince of Persia. It's got a lot of those platformer parkour elements. And well, here we are. We get a lockpick from here, which we need to go get over to the other side of the room, other side of the map, basically, to find a code that will let us see the Easter egg. For those of you who know it, well, good thing. For those of you who don't know it, it was a surprise. I mean, this is the very start of the entire Splinter Cell franchise, and this is honestly a game which I have. I need to get used to the controls I've been gaming after a long time now, especially this game. And so this is the very start of the franchise, and Splinter Cell has always been one of the favorite franchises.
We'll let you do your thing here. You're looking at your basic assault course. I'll chime back in once you've passed it.
The controls in this game are a little glitchy, and they can certainly be improved. But yeah, I mean, it is a start, and it is what it is, basically. So, So as you can see, doing stuff like wall jumps and everything else is pretty difficult in this game, primarily because it is completely, well, it is like a platformer. It is pretty much a platformer. But even then, the mechanics of the game, everything else is quite smooth. Boot is not the best version of refinement. So, there's that. Anyway, if these graphics and textures look a little too good for you, look a little too good for a game from, say, 2000s, that is because I've installed a HD texture pack which was meant for the PS3, and I'm basically using a third-party software to enable shadows and enhance lighting, and simply just use the high definition mode. So without that, it is nearly impossible to get a good resolution on this game. The general resolution of the game is
Good job, Fisher. As soon as you can find a way over the gate, we'll move on to covert ops training.
So this is basically a pretty old game, and so this is the door which we need to go to. And it just isn't as refined graphically, to say the least, as compared to the new games out there. And yeah, so that's that. So we have got this little dope-picking minigame here, and we can use this computer to gain data. Now, another thing about this game is that it's, you can see on the right-hand side of the screen, there are some tips here. And that's basically how we get information. So let me just take a moment to read this here. So the code for the observation platform with the assault post is 5656. That is the note which you got from the data stick here. The one thing I liked about this game is how in depth it goes with the data sets. With all the data and email exchanges. For example, this one from Anna Grimsortier. Those who played the series already know what this is. To Lambert, I'm anxious to see what the super spy viewers can do. So I'll be watching him from the reservation platform over the assault post. I've temporarily changed the door code to 5656 to keep anybody from wandering in. If he's as capable as you say, I'm sure we'll do fine in the field. Just don't get too optimistic, old man. Just because the brass gave us the okay to recruit him doesn't mean we're in the clear. We've still got a lot to prove here, and while Fisher may turn out to be the best thing since Audie Murphy, whoever that is, he's still just one man. A single step up and the folks upstairs will shut us down faster than a leaking reactor. Okay. And it's all these tiny little things, you know, like the banter here that makes this game feel just that much more special. It brings life to the game, to a simple puzzle stealth game. And as far as you claim that there's no such thing as a secret when Sam Fisher was looking for something, well, I'll believe it when I see it. Grim. Well, looks like we need to go talk to her then. And here we are, on the other side of the store. The door code was 5656, and this is what I was saying. They will not prompt you with the door code right here. You will need to go into your data or into your notes and check out the code that you want to access. So right now the code is 5656. Oopsie daisies. Here we have her, Anna Grimm's daughter.
Who are you?
You must be Sam Fisher. I'm Anna Grimm's daughter. Pleased to meet you.
Third echelon lead programmer.
You've done your homework.
Some of it. I'm still a little foggy on my OPSAT.
The Operation Satellite Uplink. Basically just a multi-million tax dollar PDA. But it'll tally everything you'll need to know to complete your missions. So make sure you're comfortable with the interface. No need to introduce yourself. I've already got an earful of your history from Lambert.
I'm not as mean as he says.
On the contrary, the man thinks you should be canonized.
What? The saint of shady causes?
I don't know. How about the saint of well-directed sins?
You were involved with Second Echelon, right?
Yeah, briefly. I had some ideological differences.
Like what?
It didn't respect the human element.
Were you there for the burnout in 2000?
Yeah. But I don't even have clearance to think about it.
Anyway, that's the end of the conversation with her. Now, we could knock her out right here, but that would pretty much end the game for us, so yeah, I'm not going to do that. Well, you know what? I am going to do that. Just for you guys. But first... come on. Come on. I'm gonna quick save.
Good to meet you.
God damn it, Fisher. I went out on a limb to get you recruited for this detail. What the hell are you thinking? You're fired. You're out of the agency. Game over.
Anyway, that was that. And back to the game. And we're here. Time to proceed. This is the part of being visited that becomes essential.
You're moving on into covert ops. The objective is to sneak through the area without being detected. We've got live bodies in there. Some of the top CIA instructors have kindly volunteered to be your victims.
I should have opened it gently. Now this...
the next door is locked, Sam. You'll need to use your lockpicks to get through it.
Now, we actually picked up the lockpicks in that area, and we didn't have the lockpicks before now. We just get access to it as soon as we enter this level. Luckily, we already have them. Anyway, here we have it. One of the things about this game is you can't close doors once you have unlocked them. You need to wait until the door closes itself. And yeah, I don't really know how I feel about that, but well, the game is what it is.
This next door is keypad locked. The man guarding the door has the code to open it, but he's been instructed not to cooperate. Convince him otherwise.
This is again something that I don't like about this game because, well... you need to pretty much just grab them from behind. You can't grab them from the front. And the only thing you can do is lock them out.
Hi there.
Hi!
You're not going easy on me, are you?
Not so tight, that hurts!
Sorry about that. What's the door code?
28469.
It was a pleasure working with you.
Likewise. 28469.
And the way to hide bodies in this game is simply to... Well... leave them in the shadows, where the others won't be able to see. And that's pretty much it. The way this game works is... 28469. The way this game works is...
This next door is retinal scanner locked. These things are cheap and near impossible to hack. Fortunately, it's just a matter of getting the right eyes to the scanner, usually an officer. The gentleman ahead is registered for the scanner. Convince him to open the door for you.
Yeah, so basically, the thing about the games like this is that you really need to... You just need to take them to the retinal scanner and force them to use it. This and Pandora Tomorrow, what it does is that it scans the room you just left for any bodies left in the light. And when it is done that, well, your if it just finds a body in the light, it raises an alarm. You don't need NPCs to go around and find the bodies for you. And well, it isn't the best thing, but it's what it is. So yeah, this part seems clear, and that is pretty much...
Let's work on stealth. Your gun should always be a last resort. Invisibility is your best weapon. We've got a network of photocells on your outfit connected to a visibility meter on your opsat. If the meter's at 4, you're lit up like a Dutch brothel. At 0, you're a ghost's shadow.
Oh, man. Always love the way Lambert puts things. Well, now we're in the clear, and the camera can't see. It's too bad it's not infrared.
Some cameras are more fragile, and all you'll need to do to get past them is shoot them.
I see. They want us to shoot this camera, but you don't necessarily need to do that. You can get by without shooting, it's just fine. But since the game is sort of, you know, it wants you to shoot the camera, I might as well just go ahead and do it. But here is the one area where we will need stealth.
Sometimes the only way to pass a camera will be to stick to existing shadows and time your movements.
That was a nice one to see. Now here's the thing. The stealth in this game is, well, it's like this for the most part. Sometimes it'll be good, sometimes it'll be harsh on you, and well, it's really difficult to tell how to feel about it.
Knock out the guard in the corridor and hide his body before the patrolling guard finds it.
There's like a lot of this stuff.
Okay, now Fisher, let's bring in another guard to evaluate your work.
All you need to do is just stick to the shadows. Sometimes these people have got lights, sometimes they don't. And you never really know what's gonna happen next. Well, actually, we do it. This game is scripted. And, well. This game relies a lot on the classic stealth and timing, more so.
Good work, Sam. Remember that discretion is critical to our operations. Covering up the evidence of your passing through will go a long way towards proving our usefulness in the field.
Nice. Good to know. Where are we headed to next? I wonder. Is it the sound? Yes, it is.
The next hallway's the same idea, but for sound. I'll be monitoring a few hidden mics.
Yeah, this is what you need to do here. Just three crouched, and this is something which I really liked about the game. This is the person's helmet, and this is the person's helmet. That it is pretty much like it's quite. Easy to, not easy, they focus a lot on all the elements of stealth, including sound. Now, how do I get through this, I wonder? Huh. Can I jump over this side? Well, let me try something, I forgot how to do this. Just use this pipe to get over.
Not quite soft enough. Give it another shot. Not quite.
It's still crunched under my foot.
Have you started yet? Fisher! Holy Christmas, you're at the end. Phenomenal work. Let's move on.
You feel really proud when he puts it that way, but to be honest, you know that, you know, well, you were pretty much lazy.
gotta be him.
Yep. Sam Fisher, let me introduce you to Vernon Wilkes Jr.
Hello.
Hey, I've heard crazy things about your work.
I hope you don't mind. I told him some of your stories from Kuwait.
We're all friends here.
Right on.
Junior Wilkes is a longtime NSA employee. He'll be your wheels, wings, and weapons. He coordinates transportation and equipment.
Great.
For sure. Man, you must be itching to get back out in the field, huh?
It's all I'm good at.
Well, it's all we need. Welcome to the NSA.
I'm sure things are going to come together famously. Third Echelon is a brand new initiative, and we're going to have a lot to prove.
Right.
The two of you will be Third Echelon's first team on the ground. Be ready for it, and do us proud. Welcome to the NSA.
Congratulations, sorry, CA Training Farm, Camp Peary, Virginia, August 7th, 2004, 0729 hours. It took me 1.5 hours, eh? Congratulations, Fisher. You have demonstrated that you are the right man to spearhead the NSA's Third Echelon Initiative. The onus will be on you to prove that the worth of deploying solo covert operatives by gathering intelligence in the field and taking deliberate action based on that intelligence. Welcome to the NSA. And that is it for you guys today, and I'll be uploading the actual videos of the gameplay, like the actual game, the actual levels in the following days. And well, yeah, it's a start, it's a slow start, but it's a start. Hope to see you guys more often. See you when I see you. Farewell, fellow orphans.